President Yoweri Museveni is among regional and Africa's leaders who gathered in Nairobi yesterday for the official launch of Raila Odinga's candidacy for the African Union Commission chairmanship. The event at State House Nairobi was hosted by William Ruto, the President of the Republic of Kenya. President Museveni underscored the necessity of patriotism and pan-Africanism for Africa's prosperity, citing historical instances where internal divisions led to the decline of previously successful African initiatives against external threats.
Now, the African Union is a crucial point because, as Right Honorable Odinga was saying, it is the one which can enable us to negotiate together, to put pressure on those other groups, Wazungu, Wahindi, wa China, wa America, to negotiate with them. And I am here to support the candidature of the Right Honorable Raila Odinga on behalf of Uganda, because he is a convinced Pan-Africanist.
Ruto referred to Odinga as an ideal candidate for the seat and described him as a distinguished statesman and a true Pan-Africanist.
The Honorable Raila Odinga possesses the professional capacity and experience, a proven track record of transformative leadership, and a wide experience of accomplishments at the national and regional levels. Furthermore, the Honorable Raila Odinga enjoys a sterling reputation as a zealous Pan-African who has consistently demonstrated.
Odinga shared his aspiration for a united and prosperous Africa, characterized by peace and sustainable growth.
Connecting Africa through high-speed fiber optic network, and then to facilitate faster communication. Then the issues of air transport.
Four senior African politicians have thrown their hat into the ring to take over AU's top post. These are Mohamed Ali Yusuf of Djibouti, Raila Odinga of Kenya, Richard Randriamandrato of Madagascar, and Anil Gayan of Mauritius. This year, the role is reserved for a representative from East Africa to replace Fachi, who has served since 2017. Soroti Secondary School and Mengo Senior Secondary School will face off in the Green Schools debate finals at Makere University today. This comes after the schools emerged best out of 30 teams that competed in the preliminary debate rounds at Kololo Secondary Schools yesterday. Nabisunsa Girls Secondary School and Seta High School were knocked out of the race. However, according to the organizers, the two will also face off for ranking and awarding. Among the qualities sought for by adjudicators are arguments, evidence, presentation, explanation, and speaker points.
Omugenyi omukulu ajja kubeera minister omubezi w'ebyobutonde n'amazzi Honorable Beatrice Anywar. Tusuubira okubeera ne ambassador wa Sweden, we ya Sweden mu Uganda, n'akiikirira FAO, country representative of FAO.
The Green Schools initiative was launched in 2022 with 100 secondary schools across 10 regions. Last year's championship was won by Secretary at Secondary School Muhanga from Shema, who bagged 12 million shillings. The campaign is supported by the Swedish Embassy and the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations. Uganda National Roads Authority yesterday removed the deadly traffic lights at Nkumba University that locals claimed were the main cause of accidents on the Kampala Entebbe Road. UNRA Communications Officer Alan Sempewa said they decided to remove the traffic lights in response to recent road crashes at the Nkumba traffic light section. He said that the current setup includes two traffic signals positioned approximately 100 meters apart, operating on different cycles. Sempewa said vehicles from Kampala towards Entebbe will no longer turn at this junction.
Emisana galero abakugu bafebadde ku luguudo olwo kitundu eky'enkumba era ebitala bino bijjiddwako ebisooka ebiri mu kikongo ve Kampala
The decision by UNRWA comes in the wake of the August 23rd, 2024 serious crash at the same Nkumba Lights.